I think the base metals are a freer market because they're not as influenced by some of the macro things that influences gold. People always say, how much gold do I need to own? You know, is it 20%? Is it 10%? It's a lot less than you think. You know, gold is not really an asset that you buy to go up in value tremendously to make money. You know, everybody thinks, I'm going to buy these gold coins, they're going to go crazy in value, the government's going to try to seize them, I'm going to make all that. It's not really like that. It's insurance. You know, gold does well when other things get really hurt. And so we work with a number of 3%. We kind of play with this number and we say, look, if you had 10 million bucks and you had 300 grand worth of gold, that would probably be a starting point for saying it's enough. And I think a lot of people are shocked by that. I mean, they think, wait a minute, not so much more. No, I mean, your investments, your royalty company investments, mining businesses, all these things, these are things that you would see appreciation and sell, whereas the gold you could just hold on to. I mean, everybody used to say gold doesn't pay a dividend, but the high interest savings account doesn't pay a dividend either. In fact, you know, so you arguably are going backwards. I mean, in the book, we talk about negative interest rates, which are here now. We can talk about that more. Yeah. If you look at the real rate of interest, it's negative. That means the interest rate you're being paid minus inflation. And everybody out there, the real people in this world, know inflation is really high right now. I mean, all you gotta do is go to the grocery store. Things are sold out, there's inventory shortages. I buy prime beef to cook for myself and my kids. It's over $30 a pound US right now for prime tenderloin beef. It was $20 a year ago. It's up across the board. Now, granted, that's the nicest beef you can get, but I mean, everything is up. You know, remember the paper towel shortages that we had?
That's right.
All these different things. You know, I have stock in Campbell's Soup. They run this report on what does it cost for a basic can of tomato soup over the decades. And the price of all these things is going up, 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 up. So
would it come down? That's the question.
Well, maybe, but of course, always it's possible. But what's going to make it come down? You have labor shortages.
Stop buying the beef, EB. Make the price come down.
Become a vegan. Become a vegan. The price comes down. But I hate to tell you, but the grain, you know, grain is the same way. You know, all your grains, your vegetables, supply chains are constrained. You know, the port is backed up in Los Angeles consistently for 15, 18 months. It's you're having to pay people a minimum wage that's much higher than people thought in the past.
That's right.
They're still complaining about the wage. I know where I live, there's shortages everywhere. You go to a restaurant, the service is slow, the tables are all packed. I think this is something that people are really underestimating. And so here's the point. The point is not conspiratorial. The point is your high interest savings account pays you 0.5% interest per year. If you take out an inflation rate of 2 or 3 or 4, you pick your own number. You're going backwards. So with the ounce of gold, you don't get the interest payment, which by the way is taxable and taxes are going up,
sure.
But you do get protection against that inflation. I think the base metals are a freer market because they're not as influenced by some of the macro things that influences gold. I mean, the gold price is heavily levered. You know, it moves around in the futures market. You see it slam down $20 and then shoot back up. You can have futures contracts that offer you a heavy amount of leverage. Copper's not like that, you know, and nickel's definitely not like that. I mean, you can barely even get a futures contract in nickel. We have an investor who's done that, but they had to create a product for him. It was something that wasn't even available. So the copper at 4.25, let's just call it a pound, you know, if you take it to $5, $6 a pound, which is very reasonable, the price of those royalties, you're talking 40, 50 years of expected copper output goes crazy. And so I think that gold is obviously a big focus for me. It's a business that I love very much and I'm very excited about. But the copper and nickel market, I think, is more freely trading.
The cost of financing, the cost of capital around the world is still at an all-time low. Do you see that changing anytime soon?
I mean, but not for everyone. I mean, obviously, if you try to borrow money for certain reasons, it's quite high. You know, there's still situations where people, there's usury, you know, in many of these markets. It's only held low by the central banks. You know, how long can they hold on to this? I mean, I think this is kind of a big picture thing, but I think we're transitioning into a new system. This is going to go on. It's kind of run the car as fast as you can. Until you run off a cliff and there's a fireball, and then you solve that panic. Because remember, you always have a panic, and then that gives people the courage to say, yes, we want you to fix the panic that you caused. You know how this goes? You know, so you set my house on fire, and then you show up with the hose ready to help. So it's certainly ready to rebuild for a small fee. That's how you'll see this go. So they're gonna keep this is not a real rate of return. I mean, everyone knows you work your whole life, you save up money, and then you loan it to someone for a quarter of 1% or something.
Yeah.
This doesn't work. It's broken.
Well, that's what investors would like to know, EB, yeah. is that in a low real rate environment, yeah. where do you go to yeah. find yield?
Yeah.
What investments do you go to? Bonds? No. Yeah. Gold? Maybe. I mean,
so I'm in the royalty business. I think it's for me has really been a huge creator of wealth. And what people need to understand is that, I mean, the stocks that you can buy in the market, everyone can buy in the market. This is not like some insider deal. What happens is every time gold moves just a little bit, the value of Metalla's over 70 royalties expands. And so what happens is you get credit for hundreds of thousands of ounces of gold in the ground that are going to come out in future years that are worth that much more.
Yeah.
So it's leverage in its truest form without borrowing.
How does that work? So your Metalla goes to a producer or an explorer, and they ask them for a percentage of their sales.
That doesn't
equity.
Work out very well. So we don't
so
do that.
What, you don't do
so,
that,
so
okay.
So what we do is we buy royalties in the existing market. No one else does a good job of this. This is what we do. This is our secret sauce. So we go find royalties that have been around for 10, 15 years, projects nearing development, and we buy that royalty and bring it into Metalla as part of a diversified collection.
Right.
So that seller, that royalty becomes a shareholder most of the time, not all the time, but most. We bought a royalty today on Equinox Gold.
Yeah.
It's a 5% royalty on an expansion portion of their Castle project. They would have never sold us that royalty, right? They don't need the money. They're well-financed. You know, I was with Greg last night. It's a super company with extremely strong backers like Ross Beatty. They would never give someone a 5% royalty.
That's
but
right.
we found someone that had owned that royalty for ages, I mean, decades, and wanted to sell it and sold it to us. And so now we own that royalty on Equinox, which I think is going to turn out to be really a cornerstone acquisition. And I think people are slow to see that's the seventh deal we've done this year. Seventh deal this year. I mean,
what's in
crazy.
Your portfolio in terms of metals? Is it mostly gold? Because I'm looking
it's
at
all
your
gold,
stock
silver.
Price. It
all
looks,
gold,
it looks like it tracks the gold.
Yeah,
price.
All gold, silver. That's it. Now, what we did is we created a separate company, Nova. Metalla's ticker symbol MTA on the US, trades in the NYSE. That's about 5 years ago. We started that company at 80 cents. It's about 7.50, close to $8 right now.
Yeah.
So, and it's down a lot.
Right.
So when people look, I mean, they say, well, I buy low, sell high, but it's not really true. Most people are panicking when it's $8. You know, it was 13 at the beginning of the year. But the gold market has been really tough.
Yes.
It's been really, really tough. All of the stocks in the royalty sector have been down this year. And Franco's the only exception, and that's barely flat.